welcome back to my new video. Today's video is solve max sum in configuration for a problem statement. You have given an array 0x indexing and array size is n, and your task is to find to return the maximum value of the sum in I this using this operation, okay? And where a I is the element at index I in the array, and the only one operation allow is to rotate the array any number of times. Okay, now understand this through example. First we have to need understand approach of this problem statement. First we calculate initial sum, and in initial sum first is we have to initialize sum which variable is declared as R0, and it is the original array configuration. Then we calculate total sum of all elements in the array, and variable of sum array is s. And then we next step is rotate the array and calculate the sum for each rotation. In this step we iterate through array and for each rotation, and each rotation we calculate the new sum which is r summer and directly, and keep the track maximum sum encountered. Okay, in example one, our n equals to 4 and this is our array, and first we have to create initial array sum calculation. This is our initial array, means the array which is given. So we write down that array value 8312. Okay, and we have to now calculate this array value with index value. How? First we write array index value 0. In our initial array, original array, index value is 0, add value index is 0, and then into 0 index value 8, and then plus index 1, then index 1 value 3, index 1 value is 3, and then index 2 value is 1. Okay, write this. Then we calculate all of this initial array. So now it will get, we'll get 11. Then we go to first rotation. In first rotation, we have to calculate first sum of calculation means same in the initial array, same formula. Our index value with that corresponding index and that corresponding index value element. Okay, zero index in this rotation one, you can see zero index value is 3. So we write down 0 into 3. Then this one index value is 1, means 1 into 1. Then this index 2 value is 2. Then plus 2 into 2, you can see in this sum of calculation 2 into 2. Then index 3 value into 8. Index 3 value is 8. And sum of this calculation is 29. And you can say how we create this rotation 1 array value. We just create maximum how we get combination of array. Means this is our original array. Array, then how combination we will get. We suppose in this second rotation one array value is like this 3128. This is array like this. How many rotate each original array, how many combination we will get. Then we calculate each rotation sum calculation. Okay, then in second rotation same is value is index 0 value is 1, index 0 is value is 1, and index 1 value is 2, means 0 into 1 and 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2. So you can see in the second rotation 0 into 1 index value 0, and index value 1 value is 2, index value 2 value is 3, index 3 is value 3, sum of this 27. And then go to third rotation index value 0 is 2, and 1 is 8, and 2 is 3, and 3 is 1. Now sum of these will be 17. Okay, in this rotation first, how many sum calculation we get? 11 29, 27, 17. In this, we have to find which sum calculation is maximum. In this, 23 means our first rotation, 23, this is the maximum or highest sum. So, in output, it will show 29. That's it. Now, in second example, n equals to 3 and this is array. First, we have to calculate initial array sum. This is our initial array means so we calculate through our original array. Original array is 1, 2, 3. So, we write down original array value 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This 1, 2, 3. Now, we calculate this. We calculate R0. Initial, we declare as R0. Rotation R0. Okay. First, index 0 is value is 1, so 0 into 1 index into value 0 into plus index 1 value is 2, so write down 2, then index 2 value is 3, so write down 3. Now sum of it will be 8. Now go to rotation 1. In rotation 1, we can rotate original array is 1, 2, 3. We can rotate like this in rotation 1, 2, 3, 1. All are in exit in this rotation, also must exit all values in rotation. Okay, 2, 3, 1, we can rotate it. Next, we have to, in this case, 2, 3, 1, rotation 1, 2, 3, 1, index value 0 is 2, 1 is 3, 2 is 1. Now same, we calculate this like initial array, index value 0 into index value 0 value is 2, and index 1 value is 3, index 2 value is 1. Now sum of this 5. Now in second rotation, 3, 1, 2, array is 3, 1, 2. 3, 1, 2. Now calculate this 3 is 0. 0 index, and 0 index value is 3, then index value 1 is 1, so 1 into 1 plus index value 2 is 2, so 2 into 2, then sum of this will be 5. Now in this case, how many sum calculation we find? First initial array we get 8, then first sum calculation we get 5, sum is 5, and second, in second rotation we get 5. So in this, which is maximum? In this we can see 8 is maximum, so in output it will show 8. Now pseudocode, first we calculate the initial sum which we represent at R0, and initial sum, then we sum of element, initial sum we represent at current value, write down as current value, then we create a for loop to initialize current value to n minus 1, and then next step is we initialize maximum value with our initial value, means current value. Then we calculate the sum of each rotation, we calculate each rotation sum creating a for loop from I to 1 to 1 to n minus 1. Okay, then we calculate a new sum based on previous rotation sum like through this. Then we update a max value in if new sum is greater than previous sum, then it will update to max value. Create a if condition, current value means initial value is greater than max value, then it will current value go to max value, update. Then at the last step it will return, if we get encountered maximum value, then it will return that maximum value. Now go to code. Time complexity of this O of n and space complexity is O of 1. Now in code, first we initialize our initial value, initial sum calculation, we initial at represent current value. Then we calculate sum of all elements, then create a for loop to traverse. Then we second step, we configure rotating the array, this for loop. Then if we get our maximum value, then it will return our maximum value. Already discussed in pseudocode, so no need to in this video. Now just simply compile and run. Now submit and it's done. See you in next video. Still and bye bye.